Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel and to a new episode of this human body anatomy. Today we'll dive into the eyes. We'll also learn how to draw them in different angle. We'll start first with the names, which of course you're not obliged to memorize by heart. I mean, I'm not memorizing them by heart, but but honestly, they are important in order for us to understand the location of each part. After the names, we'll be drawing the skull, I mean the eye anatomy and the eye skull. And then after that, we'll be drawing the eye planes. This sequence of drawing, and by starting with the names, then the skull, then the plane, is what I found is an important sequence in order for you guys to understand how everything function and work together. So I hope you're ready for this very interesting eye anatomy. If you are, then let's jump right into it. We'll be starting with the eyeball. The eyeball is a rounded form that sits in the eye socket, which is the orbit of the eye. The eyeball is made of the sclera, the iris, the pupil, and the cornea. The sclera is a coat that covers the eyeball. It is the white of the eye that protects the mechanisms of the eyes. The cornea is a transparent layer found on the front of the eyeball. It is a continuation of the sclera. It is what we call an eye lens. That is why there's usually a highlight on this eye lens. The iris is a pigmented and round shape of the eye, suspended between the cornea and lens. It regulates the amount of light entering the eye. It looks like a bowl. So when top light comes through, the bottom side will light up. And the pupil is the tiny little black spot found in the center of the iris through which light enters the eye. The frontal bone is a cranial bone, which forms the forehead and roof of the nasal and orbital cavities. The zygomatic bones, which are called cheekbones, they form the lateral and marginal walls of the orbit. The maxilla forms the upper part of the jaw. The lacrimal bone is a small rectangular facial bone with two surfaces and four borders. It forms the medial wall of the orbit and articulates with the inferior nasal concha and the ethmoid, the frontal and maxillary bones. The ethmoid bone is an odd-shaped bone lying between the orbital plates and the frontal bone and is anterior to the sphenoid bone. After understanding the eye anatomy, we'll jump right into the surface of the eyeball. First, we have the upper and the lower eyelids. The eyelids, they function with the help of the eye muscle by closing and opening them. Then we have the lacrimal caruncle, or simply the tear duct. The tear duct is a small, fleshy, reddish structure linked directly to the lacrimal area. We'll start first with the skull anatomy of the eye by drawing the front and profile view. As I've said earlier, the eyeball sits in the eye socket, which is formed by the maxilla, the lacrimal, and the frontal bone. When we're drawing the profile view, we notice that the eyeball is actually closer to the nasal bone, and we are only able to depict half of the eyeball. Thank you. always like to add some shading in my drawing so to make it look more realistic. Now we draw the eyeball in a three-quarter view. Perspective helps us understand that the left eyeball is a bit bigger than the right one. This is how we're able to draw a 3D view. We always start with main geometric forms, such as circle and lines, and then after that we get into the details. Thank you. sometimes I like to draw the details while shading, which means that I always start with the darkest shadow and work my way up towards the light. And by doing that, I'll be able to identify more and more details. In the end, I'll have a realistic drawing. And now the eye planes, or the anatomical planes. We'll be doing three drawings, and we'll be starting by a 3D or the three-quarter view of a single eye. Just want to tell you in this, I'm not going to be talking a lot, but in this one I'll be telling you why planes, why I've chosen to draw planes. Basically, planes, they guide us in order to understand the form and final shape. I find, personally, that they are the bridge between the skull or the anatomical skeletal system and our real face. So therefore, we'll be drawing the eyelids and the tear duct, and we'll be tracing curves to create the illusion of spheres. We'll continue by drawing a 3D and profile view of the eye planes by adding details and shadows. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'm sorry also for my let's say accent or whatever you want to call it, simply because English is not my natural language. I actually speak French, so and I hope I was clear when I talked. So yeah, and back again to the video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more art inspiration. I'll see you next time. Ciao.